Let's give you the race recap and show you how this first 250 moto broke down, and it has a major impact on our championship. Justin Barcia able to get around Marvin Muscan to grab the early lead, but that really was early in the moto because it was just the beginning of the action we were in store for. Title contenders Blake Baggett and Eli Tomac were on a run toward the front, Jeff.
Yeah, and as Barcia was out front leading the most laps like he has, competition started to close in. And watch Baggett. Goes around the outside right here. Barcia loses a little momentum, and Baggett carries the speed over the top of the hill and takes the lead. But you noticed Eli Tomac there started to close in also, so that was going to be the battle.
And the battle was on for a second here between the two teammates. It took a while for Tomac to finally get Barcia, Ricky.
Yeah, it sure did. Barcia was standing his ground too as well, and you know, thinking that he's in the championship. I think any of these guys had a shot. You can see there is going to try to get around them again as Tomac went around on the outside, and I thought Tomac was going to catch him.
And then the wheels come off right here. Tomac goes off the track. Say, okay, did he go off the track? Did he pull off on his own? He pulls the tear off, and then kind of uncharacteristic as he would pull his goggles off after he hits the red line.
Yeah, he basically overheated trying to catch Baggett. It was a phenomenal effort on the part of all three riders. Baggett ends up taking the moto win, and the Geico Honda guys were unable to actually go to the podium. They went straight back to the pits. That's how spent they were. Muscan and Hahn, fourth, fifth. Roxon, Malcolm Stewart, another good run inside the top 10, seventh. Wharton Nelson and Jeremy Martin, the rookie, finishes up inside the top 10. So, interesting. As we look through the rest of the top 20, Baker and Thompson 11th and 12th. Alex Martin, that's Jeremy's brother, finishes in 16th. And Brandon Schaar, I believe that's his first point of the year, finishing inside the top 20. Interesting how this turned out. The points now, it's even bigger. 17-point lead for Baggett, only 25 points on the line per moto. So it would take a disaster for Baggett to lose this championship. But Jeff, we've seen it happen before. It's certainly not on ice yet.
Yeah, but I talk a lot about the momentum and how coming into this event, it was Tomac that had the momentum, but now, once again, this moto, everything shifted again. Blake Baggett is in the driver's seat.
And can Tomac and Barcia even bounce back? How spent are they? Can they race hard in Moto 2?
I think they can for a little bit.
Okay.
I don't think anyone can go 100% today. It's just so hot.
Right.
You know, that you just have to pace yourself, and whoever's pace happens to be faster is who's going to win.
Well, the Moto 1, it was Baggett. That was as clutch a win as it comes. He had to deal with pressure from both of his championship rivals, and he came out on top. Can he seal the deal?